Welcome to my project bazaar.com. Let me discuss about the project low complexity ICF suppression methods utilizing cyclic prefix for OFDM systems in high mobility fading channels. Let me discuss about the abstract of the project. Orthogonal frequency division multiplexing is a modulation technique. It is orthogonal frequency division multiplexing is known to be resistant to frequency selective fading environments. This OFDM linearly operated on inter-symbol interference free part of cyclic prefix. However, then employed over doubly selective channels with high Doppler rapid time variations destroy the subcarrier orthogonality and introduce intercarrier interference. There is a need to suppress the intercarrier interference. This paper achieves to suppress the power in an ICA effect. Here derive optimum combining weights for IC suppression and produce three sets of optimal solution to this problem. One method is derived optimum combining weights, which minimize the IC power after segment combining. However, this method not consider noise environment, so that proposed method where obtained optimum combining weights that minimize the ICA plus noise power simultaneously. This second method considers only non-polluted region alone, even polluted region also having signal information. So there is need to consider polluted region also. Finally, method 3 proposed that employs entire cyclic prefix, which includes both ICA polluted region and ICA free region. This method also produces optimum combining weights, which used to minimize the average interference plus noise power. First two is used when delay spread is small, so that polluted region much small. Method 3 much outperformed when delay spread is large, with CP length is larger. In this proposed method, narrow band flat subchannels has been computed with slant that transform based radon mapping technique is used instead of Fourier transform, inserting a cyclic prefix before transmission, which can avoid inter-symbol interference. Then the channel can be equalized using one tap equalizer on each subcarrier. Let me discuss about the flow diagram for our process. First, a signal has been generated. Input signal information is converted into input data values. Thus, the data value converted into binary pattern and to given the process. The sample data to be given to the process. Then, to plot the sample data signal, the data preprocessing is data mining technique that involves transforming raw data into an understandable format. Real world data is often incomplete, inconsistent, or lacking in certain behavior or trends and is likely to contain many errors. Data preprocessing is proven method of resolving such issues. Data preprocessing prepares raw data for further processing. Data preprocessing is used database driven application such as customer relationship management and rule based applications like neural network. Next, in the OFDM implementation, orthogonal frequency division multiplexing is a method of encoding digital data on multiple carrier frequencies. OFDM has developed into a popular scheme for wideband digital communication, whether wireless or over copper wires, used in applications such as digital television or audio broadcasting, DSL internet access, wireless networks, power line networks, and 4G mobile communication. OFDM is frequency division multiplexing scheme used in multi-carrier modulation method. Large number of closely spaced orthogonal subcarrier channels are used to carry data on several parallel data streams or channels. Each subcarrier is modulated with a conventional modulation scheme. Next, such as quadrature amplitude modulation or phase shift keying at a low sample rate. In maintaining local total data rates similar to conventional signal carrier modulation scheme in the same bandwidth, a fast Fourier transform based n subcarrier OFDM system. Here the transmitter block creates the signal x of t, which is transmitted through the channel with pulse shaping. next in the ICA power minimization phase. When the system perform in high mobility environment, the OFDM not provide efficient signal, where the orthogonality will produce a inter-carrier interference. Here we derive the optimum combined weights that minimize the ICA power. Weight signal has been computed by combining the channel frequency response equivalent ICA term after segment combining and also the equivalent noise term of the combined signal. In order to find combined signal, the expected variance of the ICA term has been evaluated. Here taken time varying channel as a first order autoregressive model and fully perform the optimization problem to obtain the optimum combining weights which used to minimize the ICA power. The optimization problem solution satisfies the Karush-Kaun-Tucker condition in order to produce the optimum solution. This method performed in ICA free region not considered noise environment. This is the drawback of this method. Next in the ICA plus noise power minimization. In order to overcome above mentioned disadvantage has been done by this second approach. In this method, we also obtain the optimum combining weights that minimize the ICA power plus noise ratio. Next, this is considered noise environment and also ICA power minimization. Here combined noise power can be calculated by combining frequency domain noise vector and the phase compensation matrix. Next, finally, the optimum solution has been obtained. This method solved noise environment but not applied for ICA polluted region. ICA process performed only for ICA free region, not taken the ICA polluted region. So that we further proposed the interference plus noise ratio power minimization utilizing entire cycle prefix. In that ICA polluted region also contains signal information, thus it need to properly employ the signal segments in the ICA polluted region. Here the proposed method that employs the entire CP and obtain the optimum combining weights that minimize the average interference plus noise ratio. Finally, method 3, if the delay is spread is large, performance will be improved by the delay will be large. This method will be performed well compared with ICA power minimization and ICA plus noise power minimization. Let me discuss about the running procedure for our process. Select the OFDM team to tamper in the current folder, select the fill and run for executing this process. This will perform our 3 methods. This is the input data signal which we have passed to the OFDM channel, and this is the optimum solution for ICA power minimization, and this is the normalized ICA power versus function of Q for ICA power minimization method, and this is the BER versus SNR graph for the ICA power minimization method, and this is the optimum solution which we obtained after performing the ICA power plus noise ratio. And this is the ICA plus noise power minimization for normalized ICA power versus function of Q plot representation. This should be decreased. And this is the BER versus SNR graph for ICA plus noise power minimization. And this is the optimum solution for ICA plus noise power minimization with entire cycle prefix. And this is the normalized IC power versus function of Q for IC plus noise power minimization with the entire cycle prefix. This is the BER versus SNR graph for IC plus noise power minimization with the entire cycle prefix. This is the received data signal after the receiver side we received. And this is the final BER versus SNR graph for entire process. Here, optimized OFDM system for high mobility fading channel has been implemented with 3 methods. These methods used to reduce the power minimization of ISA free as well as ISA polluted region. Thank you.